Basic camera movement techniques were developed early on when photography and later film were invented. Early equipment was large and clunky and difficult to operate by today's standards. Early cameras could move up and down or left to right. They could tilt or pan if you had the proper mount, and zoom if you had a zoom lens. Every time we learn a new craft or skill, we need to learn the basic moves or techniques that define that function. Beginning to learn to shoot video or photos, whether for a hobby or as a budding business, requires some knowledge of the basic moves that define good video shooting practices. By the time this video is done, I'll explain to you 7 basic camera moves so you can start to master your own skills. Hi, I'm Jim Costa. I'm a photography, videography, and technology guru, and I created this blog to help you to become a tech-savvy senior. Now, my tips and advice are useful to anyone, but my specific focus is in helping senior citizens to become more familiar with technology to improve and better their lives. If you have a camera question, go ahead and leave a comment below. I do read all the comments that people leave, and yes, I actually do personally respond to them as well. I've created many other videos on improving your photography and videography skills, and I'm going to link to those in the comments section below and both during and at the end of this video, so stay tuned. If you want to learn more, remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit that bell to be notified when I upload new videos. I upload every week, and I'll be uploading more in-depth explanations of film and video photography topics. A camera exists in a three-dimensional world, and you can move anywhere along the X, Y, or Z axis. This means that it can move up and down, left and right, as well as forward and back, so that the director and camera operator can effectively communicate. There are names for each of these moves. This means that the director can give a series of verbal instructions, and the camera operator knows exactly what to do without anybody having to get out and draw diagrams. I'll be moving outside in a bit as well to shoot some video that shows what each type of camera move that I'm about to explain actually is. Move number 1 is tilting. Tilting is moving the camera's lens up or down while keeping its horizontal axis constant. Nod your head up and down like this. This is tilting. Now, why would you want to do this? Tilting is the fastest way to get from a low to a high point, or the other way around, when you want to show two things, though not necessarily at the same time. You might, for example, start focused in on the hand holding a bloody knife and then tilt up to reveal the killer. So, as I promised earlier, I stepped outside on this cold and freezing February day to demonstrate the basic camera moves that are discussed in this video. Snow is predicted for today, so I'm going to be quick because it looks like it's getting ready to start. The first move that we discussed is the tilt, and this tree is perfect for that. So I'm going to tilt up from the ground up to the top just to show you what that move is like. And of course, a tilt down is the reverse, from the top to the bottom. Camera move number 2 is the pan. Pan is moving the camera lens from one side to the other, just like this. Look to your left, then look to your right, just like this. That's panning. So why do this? Well, you might pan across the audience at a show so you can show that all the people who are there. You might pan from one character to someone who walks through the door to elevate the tension that wouldn't exist with a fast cut. If you're shooting video, for example. This is the pan. If you pan, you pan Right means panning to the right, from left to the right. Pan left means starting on the right and moving to the left. And let me just demonstrate that for you. Here's a pan right. It's screen right. And here's a pan left in the other direction. The funny thing about panning is you're moving in the screen direction, but my hand is actually moving my tripod handle to the right. It's opposite to make the move. Move number three is known as the pedestal. Now the pedestal is to move the camera up or down without changing its vertical or horizontal axis. A camera operator can do two types of pedestals. You can pedestal up, which means to move the camera up, or to pedestal down means then moving the camera straight down. You're not tilting the lens, not like a tilt, but rather you are moving the entire camera up, just like my arm is. Imagine your camera is on a tripod and you're releasing or lowering the tripod head. This is exactly where the term comes from, in fact. It's sort of like jacking up your car, if you're not sure. You put a camera jack, your car goes up, you can change your tire, let the jack down, the tire goes back down. So, why do this camera move? Well, when pedestaling, you usually want to maintain the camera to subject distance. So you might start on a person leaning up against a wall and then pedestal up and up and up until the camera gets to Spider-Man clinging to the fourth story of a building and creeping up it. Or you might pedestal from a bride and groom's hands up to their faces. For these next few moves, I've taken the camera off the tripod and I'm doing it handheld, just for to make it easier. This is the pedestal. The pedestal is literally moving the camera directly up or down without changing the focal length or its position. So in this case, I'll pedestal up this sign for the trail I'm standing on. And then I'll pedestal down. Notice that I'm not moving forward, back, or left or right. The camera is still remaining the same. It's just literally moving straight up or down. Move number four is known as the dolly. Dollying is motion towards or from one subject. The name comes from the old dolly tracks that used to be laid down for the heavy cameras to move along, very much like railroad tracks in the days before Steadicams and other types of gimbals got so popular. The phrase dolly in means to step forward towards the subject with the camera, while dolly out means to move the camera away from the subject, keeping the zoom the same. It's the same image, you're just physically getting closer or further away. Zooming the camera changes the focal length of the lens, which can introduce wide angle distortion or changes in the apparent depth of field. For this reason, it's often preferable to dolly rather than zoom, because this effect does not occur when you dolly. Now this move I'm going to demonstrate is the dolly. And remember, dolly is when you're physically moving the camera forward or backward. And this trail, this hiking trail, is a good explanation of how that works. I'm going to walk forward along the trail, trying to hold it as steady as I can, but it's cold out here. Notice that I'm moving down the trail. Trees and everything are moving beside me. That's dolly forward. And I'm just going to walk backwards a few steps. This is dolly backwards. You notice I'm not changing the focal length. I'm not doing anything, just literally moving the camera forward or back, more or less in a straight line. Now, if this is making sense to you, put Tech Savvy Senior in the comment section below. Move number five is known as the truck. Trucking is like dollying, but it involves motion from the left to the right. Truck left means to physically move the camera to the left while maintaining its perpendicular relationship. This is not to be confused with a pan, where the camera remains firmly on its axis while the lens turns to one direction or the other. Trucking is physically moving the camera and the tripod. It stays the same and it just moves back and forth like this. Whereas a pan is the camera stays in one spot, moves this way. The lens moves, but the base of the camera stays the same. You might truck left to stay with a pedestrian as she walks down the street rather than using a pan, which would show her back after she passed the camera. Now for this next move, this is the truck. In trucking, remember, is physically moving the camera, essentially left or right. So I'm walking now sideways. You have the tree in frame. And notice that I'm not moving the camera, focal length or anything. I'm simply moving the camera directly to the right, and here's a truck left. Notice how everything stays the same in frame. And here I am just walking down the trail to give you an idea. Move number six is known as the roll. To roll is to move the camera onto its side, the way a dog tilts its head when he doesn't understand. This is a very rare movement and one that you should only use for very specific purposes as you are rotating the camera pointed at in the same subject on the Z-axis. Just like this, back and forth. It stays the same. You tilt your head sideways, one direction or the other. This is known as a camera roll. Sometimes you see this in movies when someone's asleep and they wake up and the image is sideways, because that's how you see it when you first wake up and your head is laying on its side. That's a roll shot. And they're very rare because it throws off the horizontal axis of the image and it can be a little disconcerting. So you use it very sparingly. Now this next move is the camera roll. Remember, this is an extremely rare move that you're hardly ever gonna use. These logs here make a good example to show you. Here's a roll left and a roll right. Notice how odd that is to see. So because of that, you rarely use this move, only in very few specialized occasions.
Finally, move number seven is the zoom. I save zooming for last for a very specific reason, because you shouldn't really do it. Zooming is one camera move that most people are probably familiar with. It involves changing the focal length of the lens to make the subject appear closer or further away. Most video cameras today have a built-in zoom feature. Some have manual zooms as well, and many have several zoom speeds. Zooming is one of the most frequently used moves and one of the most overused moves that people use. So use it very carefully. So why would you want to zoom? Well, it's the easiest way to get from far to close or the other way around. You might start with a wide shot of a concert to set the stage and then zoom in to show the performers. Now, why did I say not to zoom, or at the very least to zoom as little as possible? Because of all the camera moves described in this video, the only one that is unnatural is zooming. You can physically move yourself to the left or right or up or down. You can swing your head around just like a pan, or you can move closer or further away from your subject and so forth. And you can mimic all the camera moves that I described in this video physically with your body. The one thing that you cannot do is to remove your eyeballs and actually move them closer to or further from whatever you're looking at. Try to avoid zooming unless absolutely necessary. Excessive zooming is a total rookie mistake because that's not something you could naturally do.
This is the zoom. Remember, this is the one move that people use the most often, probably because the zoom control is located right next to the hand grip on most cameras, so it's really easy to do, but it is the one you should do the least. So for this example, let me just go you a quick zoom in. There's a tree there, a white tree. I'm going to zoom into that. This is zooming in. And of course, I'm tight, so I pull out. That's a zoom out. It is okay to zoom from time to time when it's necessary. So like that shot,
I pulled out tight and you can reveal the valley down below and the buildings and stuff in the background. There are times to use it, just use it cautiously.
My question of the day is, what camera move technique gives you the most trouble? Leave a comment below and let us know. Do you want to see more videos like this? Follow my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films, for more. Do you think what you saw was great? Go ahead and like it. If you have an opinion, then comment below. If you know someone who could benefit from the information I provided, please share the video. Do you want to learn even more? If so, then connect with Jim Costa Films on social media and online on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, and of course on the web. I currently have over 4,200 videos on my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films, so feel free to check out many of my other videos for great tips and suggestions. Now, I also have a new Facebook group called Video Producers and Content Creators. So look for that on Facebook to connect there, join the group, and get even more pro tips and tricks.